Hi friends, welcome to World Explorer India. Today let's see some of the model questions. Total parental nutrition is isotonic fluid, hypotonic fluid, hypertonic fluid, or none of the above. So in this question, whenever such question comes, first of all we need to see what is tonicity. Tonicity is nothing but concentration of the fluid. So how can we know this? Rough estimation is sodium plus value into 2. We know the sodium value is 135 to 145 MEQ per liter. That means osmolarity will be approximately 190 or 170 to 190. So we know that TPN osmolarity is hypertonic. Answer is hypertonic, because the osmolarity of TPN is 750 milli osmol per liter. So our normal osmolarity is 280 to 300 approximately. So answer will be hypertonic solution. Next, what all the TPN contains? TPN contains essential amino acids, non-essential amino acids, both of the above or none of the above. Total parenteral nutrition. We are giving all the nutrition to the patient by parenteral route, that means intravenous route. Other than the enteral route is called as parenteral route. So answer is, here we are giving all the amino acids, that is both essential amino acids and also the non-essential amino acids we are giving through TPN. Next question, which of the following is non-essential amino acid? Glycine, lysine, methionine, leucine. Answer is glycine. Glycine is non-essential amino acid and remaining all are essential amino acids. So now we will see what are all the non-essential amino acids. Non-essential amino acids are alanine, arginine, glycine, histidine, proline, serine and tyrosine. Next question, which of the following is essential amino acid? Histidine, tyrosine, tryptophan and serine. Now answer is tryptophan. Tryptophan is the essential amino acid. So all the essential amino acids are leucine, phenylephrine, methionine, lysine, isoleucine, valine, threonine and tryptophan. So answer will be tryptophan. Allen test is done before the procedure of central venous catheterization, coronary artery bypass graft, hemodialysis, arterial blood gas analysis. Answer is arterial blood gas analysis. So what is Allen test? Allen test is, we are checking the patency of the radial artery and brachial artery. We have to see whether collateral circulation is in functional or not. So what we do? We block both the radial and brachial artery and we ask the person to fist for 10 times and open. Then we see, we will release one artery, that is either radial or brachial, and we see the blood flow is there or not. If blood flow is intact, then only we are going to do ABG. Otherwise, we are not going to do ABG procedure. So this is most essential test in ICU we do every day. That is Allen test. Which of the following is not included in TORCH complex? Toxoplasmosis, rubella, cytomegalovirus and haemophilus. TORCH includes toxoplasmosis, rubella, cytomegalovirus and herpes. It's not haemophilus. So answer is toxoplasmosis, others, rubella, cytomegalovirus and herpes. So which is not included here is haemophilus. It is herpes. What is the short angle of the clock at 10:28 PM? Now whenever such question comes, you should be very careful and you should be keep in mind about the hours hand and also the minute hand. Now answers are 134 degrees, 148 degrees, 160 degrees and 180 degrees. So answer will be 148 degrees, because you know that 360 degrees is equal to 60 minute. That means every minute is equal to 6 degrees. First concept is every minute is equal to 6 degrees. Second thing, hours hand moves 1 degree for every 2 minutes, because you know that for 1 hour it is moving only 5 degrees. That is 5 minutes, sorry. Our hand is moving 5 minutes. That means 5 into 6, that is equal to 30 degrees. So, in 60 minutes, our hand is moving 30 degrees. That means it moves only 1 degree for every 2 minutes. Understand? Next, minutes hand moves 6 degrees for every minute. Next thing, for every 5 minutes, there is 30 degrees. If you know all these calculations, be very careful about hours hand and minutes hand, how much is the moving. So, if you are calculating all the minutes, then it will be 148 degrees. That is the answer. Which of the following is not a mode of ventilation? PSMV, VAC, CPAP, DPV. We know that SMV is synchronized intermittent mandatory ventilation, VAC is volume assist control mode, CPAP is continuous positive airway pressure, DPV there is no such ventilation, it is just a confusing answer for you. Answer is D. So modes of ventilation are SMV, that is synchronized intermittent mandatory ventilation, VAC volume assist control mode, CPAP is continuous positive airway pressure. Next, donation of blood should not be less than for next blood donation. Means if you are giving one blood donation, when you can give the next blood donation? That is the question. Answer is 8 weeks, 12 weeks, 16 weeks or 20 weeks. So there should be minimum 3 months gap, that is approximately 12 weeks. Answer is 12 weeks for the next blood donation. So if you like this question, subscribe, like, comment and share to your friends. Thank you.